We've been telling Toronto stories for 50 years. A trip down memory lane as CFTO looks back to day one.
CTV News.
Well, as we look ahead to 2011, we can't help but look back. This year, well, is extra special for us.
You see, this week we mark quite a milestone. Our television station will celebrate 50 years of broadcasting. Tonight, we give you a taste of that very first day in 1961.
The new Impala convertible.
It was the beginning of a new decade. The year was 1961.
The president-elect and Mrs. Kennedy.
The United States was about to welcome a handsome young president and his wife to the White House. They had just come home with a new son named after his father. John Diefenbaker governed on Parliament Hill as Canada's prime minister. At the movies, Swiss Family Robinson was number one. And in January of 1961, the king ruled the radio.
Is your heart filled with pain?
Elvis Presley had a string of hits, but that month, Are You Lonesome Tonight topped the Billboard's charts.
Tell me, dear, are you lonesome tonight?
And here in Toronto, history was about to be made. A new television station in the remote community of Agincourt was about to sign on. It was Sunday, January 1st, New Year's Day. The station was called CFTO, the most elaborate, cutting-edge television station in North America.
Nice to see you, my dear.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
You heard it, didn't you?
I did.
Pat Causway and Brian Purdy were there on day one 50 years ago. They were among more than 100 employees from Toronto, other parts of Canada, the United States, and the UK, who came together to make television magic. Pat worked at the CBC when the phone rang. A new station was looking for people.
I said, what's CFTO? He said, it's a new private station license that's just been granted. And I'm going as executive producer. I'd like you to come with me. And I thought it over and I said, yes. I was 20 years old then and I thought, that sounds like an adventure.
Big raise?
Oh, $5 a week. It was pretty remote. It was very rural. It was a sleepy town of Agincourt. The only construction was the CFTO station. And we had to get here by hook or by crook, which we did.
CFTO was an idea brought to life by four wise men, Foster Hewitt, Joel Aldred, Ted Rogers, and John Bassett. Together, they applied for and received a license from the then Board of Broadcast Governors.
Before we went on the air, getting everything ready, because we'd set the target for New Year's Eve, can only be described in two words. Total chaos.
While engineers and the technical staff raced against time wiring the station for sound and pictures, the old Toronto Telegram featured the new station prominently in its December 31st edition. New RCA cameras were being used to broadcast the signal across southern Ontario. It documented the station's weekly lineup, which featured both Canadian and American programming. Ray Purdy was responsible for picking those shows. Before coming to CFTO, he had worked for CBS in New York and in Scotland. His son, Brian Purdy, was beside his father in the control room when the station went to air.
So let's have a drum roll right now.
The first show was a telethon. It raised more than $200,000 for children with special needs. He recalls the tension, the nerves, and the problems just minutes before showtime.
Well, I think they had some camera problems or they had some wiring problems. And they couldn't get a picture. I was up in the control room, and it was a countdown, 30 minutes, 20 minutes, 15, and then all of a sudden they were ready to go. So there was a lot of tension going. And once they're off and running, it was the excitement of being on air, knowing the signal was going out the antenna at that time. And we were, helicopters were used to bring some of the guest stars in from downtown for the telethon. It was very exciting.
Before moving into the new digs on what's now known as Channel 9 Court, shows were pre-taped at a plant in Kleinburg. Carol Taylor and Johnny F. Bassett hosted After 4, Talk and Entertainment, just for teens. They introduced Toronto to Joni Mitchell and Gordon Lightfoot, who was a regular host. Folk music was big. Let's Sing Out often featured performers who would later become household names, including these guys. A television first, right here at CFTO.
And the sign said the words of the prophets are written on the subway wall.
Canadian Talent Showcase featured the up-and-comers as well as the established. For Night Owls, there was Better Light with host Rick Campbell. There were quiz shows, cooking shows, and of course, CFTO News, then known as Worldbeat News. And 50 years later, CFTO News is still the number one newscast in the number one market in Canada. Our position in the ratings hasn't changed. Fortunately, our news vehicles sure have. And when broadcasters got the green light to bring color to living rooms across Toronto, John Bassett, as always, wanted to be first.
And I got permission from the BBG ahead of the date, about 6 weeks, I think, 2 months perhaps, to broadcast in color on an experimental basis.
We built the station for color because Canada wasn't allowed to have color. Can you imagine?
In addition to all those shows, CFTO was also in the sports game, broadcasting the CFL and even the Toronto Maple Leafs when the Leafs were winning Stanley Cups. Here's the original sports department. It was led by Johnny Esau. That's Johnny on the right. 50 years, thousands of hours on the air with millions of viewers watching. It's been a remarkable ride. Pat Causeway and Brian Purdy will treasure every moment because, after all, they had a front row seat to Canadian television history.
And we will take you down our memory lane throughout the week as we celebrate our 50th anniversary. Tomorrow, we look at the iconic television shows that left a mark on all of us over the past five decades. And as we look back this week, next week, we look forward, 50 years forward. We begin a week-long series of Toronto 2061 that starts next Monday at 6:00.